The role of youth today, it's I think it's incredibly exciting, no? It's I consider myself youth, no? And I've considered myself youth for the past 20 years. Particularly today, it's generation Y, no? Or generation next, however you want to call it. But it's the conditions are, depends on how you want to frame it, no? So in a way, you have one of the most challenging environments that we will be facing. No, climate change is no longer a if, it we will be living through it, so how do we go about it, and many other challenges that we have. And at the same time, we are so connected, so open to actually think of much more than just getting a job and doing stuff, but actually finding something that's meaningful for us. So in that sense, I think that the opportunities that the youth have today are incredible, are exciting, no? To be part of it. I'm part of the previous generation, and in our time, most of my friends come actually from ISEC, no? And we would struggle so much to find jobs, to create some entrepreneurial culture or space for social entrepreneurship or for social innovation, because there was nothing of it at all, no? And today you have many companies speaking of it. Most of them are just maybe speaking of it, still not walking the talk, but nonetheless, that's putting already some pressure on them of, okay, if I want to attract and retain this top talent, I have to live and embody these values, no? And the youth right now don't only want to work for a company that pays the bill or their bills, they want to work for something that has meaning for them. And if they don't find it outside, they'll create it themselves. So that opportunity that you have today, it's not in the future, it is today. And same again, the opportunity right now being in ISEC, it couldn't be any better than if you would be anywhere else. No? The forum you speak for, it's very exciting. No? As I told you, this is my sixth IC, and I've taken part in many other ISEC conferences. And I like first how it started as youth to business, and now how it has transformed into youth speak. And in a way, I think it's a very small but fundamental shift into how do we tap into the strength of youth. No, and most companies know that millennials are their top target. They want to understand them. There are so many studies about millennials, and yet it's so difficult for them to approach them, to understand them. So that's shifting that conversation from as ISECers asking for help to suddenly putting into value the core value proposition that you have, no? The core competencies of, hey, we are the youth. We give voice to a lot of youth in more than 126 countries, no? So how do we put that into action, no? And so it's a very good mix of getting inspired by people that are doing stuff, yeah, but by getting your hands dirty on, okay, so then what do we do about it? And then turning that into actions. I think that the combination, it's very, very interesting, very deep, and it's only the beginning. In that sense, what you put into the system is what you'll get out of the system. So put your hearts into these types of projects. It will definitely pay off. I think it's very exciting, the opportunity that you guys are having today. You know, thinking of ISEC 2020, it's such a privilege. You know, I remember when they were drafting ISEC 2015, you know, and it seemed like, oh my gosh, it's 2015, it's so far away, you know? And you've actually not only accomplished it, but you've gone beyond what you had thought before, you know? So in a way, I think it's incredible to be part of something bigger than ourselves. And ISEC gives you that opportunity at a very young age. You know, you can be working at a country that you had never even dreamed of being at, and then suddenly you're saying, hey, I'm a MCP from Cambodia, or and even though you come from Panama or Mexico or wherever. No? So it really transforms you with real facts into a global citizen. No? So that in itself, it's enabling you to do it. No? But then also framing what you dream that ISEC should be from your LCPs, MCPs, you name it. You just have this incredible network that people are actually putting those dreams into real actions. No? So visualizing it gives you a common purpose, and then it allows you actually to go year by year to actually being pivoting the different actions that you take so that you can actually make a broader difference. No? And right now it's a time to dream, and there's no better time actually to dream big, but with the feet in the ground, no? With real results.